What is up, guys? I wanted to tell you, color grading, it doesn't matter. Okay, that's a lie. It really matters. It makes your shots beautiful, cinematic, they look good. But how can you get your shots to go from this to this in Final Cut Pro if you don't exactly know what you're doing? That's what we'll be going over today, is a basic yet detailed guide of color grading in Final Cut Pro. Here we go. Okay, so there are three things you need to be thinking of when color grading. The first one, exposure. The second, color balancing. And the third is mood, the mood of the shot. We will be going over all three of those today. So you have your shot here and it looks good. It's well lit and it's just a good looking shot, but you want to make it more cinematic and make it pop a little bit more. So what you're going to do is press Command 6 to open up the color wheels and Command 7 to open up your scopes. I would pull up the Luma waveform here. So you have your color wheels over here, which can adjust your colors, your saturation on these sliders, as well as your exposure for highlights, midtones, shadows, and the whole thing. So we are going to right now mess with the exposure sliders. So if you look right here, the goal of changing your exposure is to expand your dynamic range here. So I want it to extend up to about 100, any higher and you get a bleach bypass look. And I want to bring my shadows down to 0. If you go past 0, it really crushes the blacks. And maybe I'll bring down my midtones a little bit. I did a video on skin tones, so check that out. You want to make sure your skin tones are within a certain IRE, and you also want to make sure they're true to their natural color, which you can see on this vector scope, so check out that video. But already this looks much better. I will increase the saturation a tad. You don't want to go too much, and look at that. That's already popping a lot more. The next thing we're going to do is work on color balancing. Now this shot is already colored pretty well. Really, the goal of color balancing is to normalize shots. So if you have something reflecting in that's giving your shot an off color, or if maybe you set your white balance wrong in the camera, this is how you can correct it in post. So this shot's really fine. I found a shot of just an elephant that I took that was horrendous. So what I'm gonna do is open up the color wheels, and if you look, it is blue. The shot is blue. So what you're gonna do, whatever color your shot is more of, you're going to take your sliders and push it away from that color. So the whole shot here is pretty blue. So I'm going to use the master and I'm going to push away from the blue in this section right here. And already that's looking better. Maybe since this is the darker part, it's the shadows, I'll move this over a little bit more. And I mean, it's not a great shot. It wasn't a great shot to start with, but I think that saved it. So you can do this with any shot that you think has been ruined by something reflecting in or is just a different color. You can just mess with these wheels and take that color out. But it's always good to get it right before you enter the editing room as well. And the last thing we're going to do is talk about mood. Now this is totally subjective. It's a stylized choice. You can change the mood however you would like. I use LUTs that I find that they make my time in the editing room much shorter. I'm able to grade faster, and so I suggest using a LUT. But if you want to go old-fashioned, then you can mess with these wheels here, and you have the color slider here. So let's say I'll push the highlights into the greens a little bit more, maybe the shadows a little bit more red. Maybe push the master a little bit. Nope, that doesn't look very good. And right here, basically just tweak it until you find something that you like. I don't think that looks bad. I think that looks pretty good. I think that's doable. But like I said, you can use LUTs. I highly recommend them. I did a video on LUTs if you guys want to check out that and how to make your LUTs look good on your video. Check it out after this video. And don't forget to subscribe, guys. I post videos like this every week to help you become a better videographer.